We're at the Salford City Boxing Academy here in Earlham. Very pleased to say I'm joined by Huey Fury. Good to see you, Huey.
Good to see you too, pal.
How long have you been back training since the Christmas period?
All over it. Carried on training all the way through, through the fight, obviously. We didn't end up fighting, so I ended up just getting over the virus and then straight back in the gym.
Tell us what happened now. We're just speaking about that, weren't we? The last fight, yeah, he was fighting in
Monte Carlo.
So yeah, and you had to pull out because of illness.
Illness come down a virus on the Tuesday, so try to get over it, and it just kept getting worse and worse. So end up in a bad way, and it's one of them. Just couldn't able to fight.
What was it exactly? What was you? What was your symptoms?
I had full green phlegm coming off the chest. All my head was full of, I think it was like the flu and stuff as well. And I just couldn't breathe, done a few pads and that. And I was very drained, lethargic. And it was just a gutted thing because we'd done 3 weeks up in Holland, good training camp. It was a great training camp as well. So everything went to plan and we'd done a good camp and stuff. And then being that on fight week was devastating.
Gutted.
Was gutted, but
fly over there as well. So did it come on over there, the virus?
Yeah,
how long was you there before it came on?
It was there a week before. It just hit me straight away. So I was over there.
So you got there.
Just one of them.
Changing weather.
Yeah, definitely.
Sounds like you've had what everyone else has had. Everyone seems to have been going around as well. That so.
Yeah, so I.
You might have brought it back with you.
Probably.
So yeah, it's. There's nothing worse as you've trained hard for the fight.
No,
you've
got travel over there. Everything what we've been working on in the camps has not gone to waste. It's just probably just more improved now and just fine-tuned. So I'm still looking forward to showing the people on the fight now, the next one. And just keep going, gaining forward. So everything's heading in the right direction.
I came in a few days after, I think, if not a week after the Povetkin fight you had, and you was in the gym training then. I mean, it was a few days after, something like that. So you were straight back in after that.
I remember speaking
to you about that.
I was just eyeing that because I've seen in that fight, especially that fight, the weaknesses. That was the more the icing on the cake. That was where we found out really what was going on. So, like I say, we find out a lot. And one of them, I went straight back to the drawing board, straight back in the gym and training away because, listen, it's like anything, the fight was close in that, but I know I'm capable of doing a lot more better than that and in a lot more fashion to beating these opponents. But everything happens for a reason in life. You just got to keep thinking positive and marking the ways. Like I say, I'm only just 25 and everything's going in the right direction. I'm looking forward to it now. I'm actually more confident to actually show people the change around and actually. It's actually going to be laughable in one way, but it's like I say, everything I'm so easy. It's going to be good to finally get on the right track and move forward now, instead of always being jammed in the middle. So now everything will turn around.
I really commend you for that attitude as well, what you have, because there's a lot of fighters that might have broke, you know, the defeats that you've had and the disappointments going to that up to that level, the world title fight, and you it's arguably that you won that fight. I know you believe you did, but you know, from them setbacks and them losses, you've just still gone into fight, difficult fight after difficult fight. You've not had it easy, but you've still got the determination. It proves
I know 100% that I'm capable of beating these people and being right there world level and being world champion. So if I had any doubt in my mind that I wasn't capable, it was always just these twitches and that, and it'll all make sense in the long run. And I'll get there. It's just now it's just about putting all into practice and all into play during the next fight.
In a pro for 7 years? 25, 7 years?
Yeah.
18, weren't you?
18, so.
And you're still a young man. You're young heavyweight. Yeah, you are. I know we always say this, don't we?
Yeah, people just turn pro at this age, but it's one of them. I'm all now just very set. And it's all in the bank. It's just all that experience behind me now. I'm just looking forward to putting all into practice and showing now the difference, what we've been working on, and what we've improved on. So everyone's going to see a big shock anyway with everything.
A surprise, is it then you've got in?
It's definitely a surprise.
Yeah, I won't ask you then what it is.
No, you can't ask me, I won't tell you.
No. Do you know what fights, do you watch your fights back?
Yeah, I watch all my fights back, and that's what I mean. Watch the fights, and to be honest with you, when I watch them, I kick myself because I know I'm capable of beating these in a lot more fashion. It's just the things I wasn't doing or I couldn't do. But that's what I mean. And not because these opponents, I didn't believe they was better than me. They couldn't do anything with me. They couldn't wobble me. They couldn't do nothing at all. I was there. The only person who beat, I beat myself. That was it. There was nothing. The opponent couldn't do nothing with me. It was all to do with what I was doing. So I'm just looking forward now. Like I said, I'm not giving nothing away, and we'll just see. Everything happens for a reason. Obviously, I got picked the hard route in life, but just got to keep mentally through and keep breaking through barriers.
Which fight, you said there, you get frustrated when you're watching. Which one frustrates you the most, where you're throwing punches watching it almost? You could have done so much better.
Every single one of them. Even when I go to sleep at night, I even dream of these fights where even it plays back in my head, and I see all these things what I wasn't doing, and all these kicked myself where I knew I was 100% capable of winning these fights. But everything else for a reason, so you just got to take the positives out of it. There's more experience in the bank, and now it's just going now with a new outlook, and people seeing the difference.
And it's like that drives you on to prove not only other people but yourself.
100%. I don't really. Other people can always have a say. You always have haters and stuff. I've never really been interested in that. It's always just been about proving to myself to get what I get. I already know deep down that I believe that I can get to the top. Now it's just putting it all into practice. Now everything's revealing the right way, and it's all coming together.
Mm-hmm. You started that Povetkin's fight so well. You won the first few rounds, I'm sure, and then you did. And then it kind of thing, what did you put that down to?
It was one of them. Like I say, it will make sense in the next fight. Like I said, I'm not going to give too much away, but it's one of them. The fight was a lot closer. I'm not really bothered about decisions and stuff. With that fight, what was the main now is getting to where I'm at now. And them fights I won again. I won that Povetkin fight. I want the Pulev fight, I want the Parker fight, because believe me, I know full well I'm capable of beating them in a better fashion than anything. So the main thing is now is just get this fight out of the way and then leap forward in a good fashion and hopefully get revenge on all them fighters. Mm.
What is next? What have you got anything you can say at the moment, or you have got something lined up in the pipeline?
Lined up, no opponent yet, so we're just waiting now. I think just waiting for a date to be confirmed, and then back out soon.
But we're talking the next couple of months?
Yeah, next couple of months, hopefully, straight back out. So I'm ready anyway. I've been in camp all the time, training non-stop, so yeah, ready to go.
The first time I did an interview like this with you was, I think it was in Warrington when you lived down there, and you were 17, ready to turn pro. You just won the championships, I think.
World Championships.
I don't know if you remember it, but I remember it. But
my memory's terrible, but I have got an idea. It was in the other gym, wasn't it?
Yeah, where the site was.
Yeah, Ollibank. Yeah.
And you was then very adamant you was going to be a world champion one day. I look sitting in front of you now, it's the same eyes looking at me, the same determination and the same dream that you've always had since that age.
And like you say,
it's not ever gone off track, no matter what's been put in your way.
No, it hasn't gone off track. Like I say, everything happens for a reason. I always say that because I truly believe in it. All the downfalls in life, I've been given the hard route, and I take it with both hands. I accept that, and I'm going to break through that and show people, even show myself, that I'm capable of being world champion. People will probably laugh or whatever, but when I'm in there doing the job, and they'll see. I've been holding myself back, and people realise after these few fights that I've been coping with what I've been doing is a miracle. So it's one of them. I'm just looking forward now just to march on with this year, and be a very good year. I'm looking forward to it.
Well, I do wish you all the best. You've had your setbacks one way or another with
different
things.
All behind now. So like I say, I've had some bad luck in the past. I've had a lot of bad luck, but now it's all about to change, and I'm looking forward to it.
I admire your perseverance, and I wish you all the very best of luck, Huey.
Thank you very much.
God bless you, sir.
You too.
See you soon, man.
All the best.